Okay, what is up, bros and broesses? It is Paul here from Two Man Productions, bringing you a quick video on how to download custom zombie maps. And just say before this video fully gets into it, that if this does help you, please be sure to hit that like button, and if you want your friends to know about how to do this and they want to know, hit that share button. It really does help me out. But anyway, starting off is, you'll want to open up your internet browser and go to this website called Zombie Modding. You can just go to Google, like so, and then Zombie Modding, like so, and then it'll be the first one there, and you come on to the homepage like this. Now, I'd recommend signing in. It's the best thing to really do, and then you can go to the forums or something, and you have all that kind of stuff. But you can just search for the maps in the downloads, and you can choose World at War, obviously, for this World at War download. And I'm just downloading this map here, and you'll come up with like this kind of thing, but you'll need to click download and then it'll come onto this, and then you get it in a .exe form. That's the best thing about this website, Zombie Modding, is that it comes in a .exe form that really does help out. But some of them doesn't actually always come in a .exe form, and I'm going to show you, while that finishes downloading, how to actually get it in not .exe form. So basically what you want to start off by doing is going to your computer and then head over to your desktop and click on your user, mine's Paul, and that you might have app data there. If you don't, you can close that down and type in percentage app data percentage, like so, enter, and then this is the way that I usually do it, and then go back to app data, hit local, and then scroll down until you find Activision. Mine's at the top because it's in alphabetical. And then you see COD World at War, and then mods. You can just drag and drop it straight in there, and if it's in a folder like this, if it's in a zip, extract it all out, and then it'll all be in there. And then once you launch your zombies, it will be in your mod folder. I will show you that, guys, in a second, where it'll be. And as you can see, this is just finishing downloading here. Well, this just quickly finishes downloading. 3, 2, 1. You should have something that looks like this when it opens. When this opens up like now, you'll see something like this pop up, and I'm just going to click don't tell me again. I trust this thing, but it'll pop up with something like this. Welcome to Zombie Modding Map / Installer, and it'll tell you all this stuff. You can just hit install, and you'll have to go through all the installing process of actually installing the actual thing onto your computer, this thing here, Zombie Modding. But once you've installed it, it just installs the map straight away like that, and as you can see, it might take a minute or two to fully install, but once it has, you will have the map, and you will see how it actually works once you're into World at War. And yeah, that's how it will really roll. You can turn off shortcut, and you can just search in your bar if you ever need it, but anyway, I will see you guys. Okay, so now, guys, once you're on your World at War, you will see this little mods tab that will already be there before you've even downloaded any mods. But anyway, once these are all my already installed mods, and as you can see, this is our newest mod installed. So what you want to do is click launch, and it will restart itself. And so, guys, once it's restarted itself, as you can see, this is what it might look like. You can see launch without mods if you want to go back to your normal World at War. But as you can see, you can just click on solo, and then it might look like this for, because they haven't made an emblem for the map, it might just look like that. So don't be worried like I've installed it wrong or something. That's what it's meant to look like, and that's just kind of what happens. Just to show you guys that this actually does work, I will actually show you some in-game footage right now of what it actually looks like, and hopefully this will help you guys out so you can play with your friends. You can always play in co-op. I'll show you how to set it up in co-op as well if you want to play with your friends. And this is basically showing you guys that it actually works here. Should be loaded now. Should be loaded now. And yeah, here we are. So as you can see, guys, it does work. So you guys know this works. This is, I'm guessing this looks like the COD 4 map. Yeah, it's the COD 4 map. But yeah, guys, this shows you that it actually works. But thank you for watching. If this has helped you, then I really would appreciate it if you could drop a like. As you can see, I just died there because I'm not really actually trying. just quickly head out and quit. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this really has helped. Just one thing before I do go is going to be this cooperative. You can just host an online game. You go to your game setup and make sure it's not on that. When you see this here, and I was saying that it's meant to be like that, don't get fooled. It still says co-op campaign, so change it to Nazi Zombies, and you can just call the server name whatever you want, like hi or something like that. Maximum players, you can put a password so you don't want any random people joining. You can have game chat and all that. Click OK, and then you can just invite your friends on Black Ops and all that, and then it'll all be working happily like that. So I hope this guy's has helped you, and if it has, please be sure to drop a like, and if you have got any problems, leave it in the comment section below, and if you do want to share this out, if your friends need help as well, then please do, that really does help me out. But anyway guys, hope this has helped you, I will see you soon, once again from me, Paul.